friends, let's start a journey with our very own apostle, the apostle of India, Saint Thomas. Even if he was born in the first century AD, he was just a human like us and was specially chosen by Jesus to be among his close 12. And he truly was a loyal follower. Once, when Jesus had to go to Jerusalem, risking his life, that's when Saint Thomas steps in and says, "Let's also go and die with him." That's his loyalty, guys, to be with his master, come what may. And it was that same apostle who, when Jesus died, I won't say he was a doubter, but he was so sad at his master's death, he couldn't really believe that he had really risen. But after actually seeing Jesus, he declared from the bottom of his heart, "My Lord and my God." And that declaration brought him to our country, India. St. Thomas was the first one to come this far, 2000 years back. It was not an easy task with no electricity, no smartphones, and no language to communicate with the people. What he had was a love for Jesus in his heart. And with that, he came to India to fulfill what his master had commanded him. He brought the good news of great joy to the people of India. And what he got in return was to be stabbed and killed by a spear. But that didn't bother him much. He had a beautiful home and a loving father waiting for him in heaven. What moved Thomas was his love for his Lord and Master. It's time to think, is Jesus really our Lord and Master? If he really is, it's time to get out of our houses and give this good news of great joy which we have received to the people who are living near us.